Exactly, mm-hmm. But now it's a thing, and we're going to talk about it. 6% of couples in the U.S. do live apart. That number is higher in Europe. That's 10%. It's happening in Europe.
We missing out on something
Maybe.
Here?
Maybe. We got it all wrong.
So what are the benefits, and are there any downfalls to this? We've got relationship expert Dr. Gilda Carle here joining us this morning. She also has a book, Don't Bet on the Prince.
That's
so
right.
You don't really think this is a good idea?
I think just as you all said, it has to depend on the people.
Mm-hmm.
Some people are needier. Some
Olivia, can we get one shot
of her? She said it.
And we were all like, yeah, we can see that.
And other people need more distance.
Yeah. So it's about knowing who you're getting into a relationship with.
Starting out with knowing who you are and what your needs are.
Right.
Because a lot of the people who are doing this kind of setup have found that they've been in marriages, they haven't been all that pleasant, and they're turned off to marriage in general, or close proximity.
Yeah.
So they figure, oh, it's nice to have somebody around. But in this situation with this couple, she said when he calls during the week, she gets panicky.
What does he want?
You know, how much distance
is too much? Sick of this guy. He's always calling me.
How much distance is too much distance?
That's the question.
And that's not for everybody. Everybody is different for this. But when somebody comes to me and they say, well, you know, I don't have enough of him or her, then you start to wonder if this is not the model for them.
I was telling you, a buddy of mine, his wife has the master bathroom upstairs. His bathroom is down in the basement next to his office. He said that was awesome.
So what are you
saying? So he's learned. Look, there are three parts to every relationship. You, me, and we.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in a lot of these relationships that are distance-oriented, the we part did not work out.
Okay.
So they're going back to you and me.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes that allows them to be very selfish, self-centered, and to self-caring, which to a point is nice, but one guy said to me, one of my clients said to me, but I miss my wife, I miss hand-holding, I miss seeing her and discussing our day daily.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of thing you're not going to have.
Yeah. So how do you, as a relationship expert, give people advice on this? How do you know whether or not they need distance or if they just have a problematic relationship?
Well, it's not for me to know. It's for them to know first. So then we have to scoop out what's happening in their lives so we can talk about what their particular needs are. Once we establish what their needs are, then they can find an appropriate mate to meet their needs.
Mm-hmm.
But if they don't know what they want, they will find themselves getting into situations that are very uncomfortable for them because they may want more proximity, he may not. She may want more proximity, he may not.
Can get really complicated.
Or vice versa.
Yeah.
And that will cause tremendous conflict. Mm-hmm. And we didn't even discuss the children.
Right, that's a whole nother thing. Well, so when you're together, it's important, though, to still have your own space, right?
Well, that's the thing. What this does is try to marry two things, two opposing eyes, as we have come to learn, intimacy and independence. People seem to believe that once you are intimate with somebody, you're going to lose your independence.
Mm-hmm.
And you see, that is the wrong way to have a relationship.
Yeah.
That's why I'm always going to be in business.
That's the truth. You know, and she knows her stuff. She's given all of her advice on Sally, Jesse, Raphael, and a whole bunch of other national. She knows what she's talking about. Thank you so much for being here.
Your
insight is so interesting.
My pleasure. This could go on and on and on, this
discussion.
It might be good to have her cell phone. Hey, so this happened last night. What do you think?
Phone lines are always
open.
Run for the hills. 1-800-HELP.